The trial of former Senator Laila de Lima on drug charges resumed at the Muntinlupa Court. Her very own Johnson Manabado joins us with an update. Johnson, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon. Former Philippine Senator Laila de Lima once again attended a court hearing in Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court this morning. Heavily guarded by members of the Philippine National Police, de Lima arrived at the Hall of Justice and went straight to Branch 204. There was no statement or media interviews from the former lawmaker when she arrived. Former Bureau of Corrections officer in charge, Rafael Ragos, who recanted his testimonies against de Lima, is also present during the hearing. He was cross-examined by the prosecution panel. Ragos was the acting Bureau Corps chief in 2012. Among his allegations was that he delivered money on two occasions to de Lima's home as instructed by a convict. His story was part of allegations that de Lima, former Justice Secretary, enabled illegal drug trade inside the New Bilibid prison and collected money to allegedly fund her 2016 senatorial bid. Former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre II yesterday pushed back against the restriction of Ragos, warning him to he could face charges and be jailed for taking back his claims against de Lima. Secretary Aguirre, or former Secretary Aguirre, called Ragos a liar and denied he forced him to execute any affidavit. He even presented a video recording of Ragos supposedly freely and spontaneously narrating to a lawyer from the public attorney's office his allegations against de Lima. The video was taken during the execution of Ragos' supplemental affidavit on September 26, 2016, and was shown to him by Pauchi Persida Acosta. Meanwhile, Attorney Filimon Bonita Cardon said the prosecution tried to play the video in court, but it was not decided during the hearing. Senior Assistant City Prosecutor Rudy Racamora, or Ricamora Jr., from the prosecution panel said it is important to play the video to show that Ragos was not coerced when he made his affidavit in September 2016. For the defense panel, Attorney Tacardon is confident that Ragos' recantation will have a big role in the case against de Lima. Ragos' counsel, Attorney Michael De Castro, said that during the cross-examination, his client told the court he feared for his career, his life, and of his family when he was coerced by then-Justice Secretary Aguirre. De Castro adds Ragos recalled that in 2016, many people died because of the Operation Tukang. The defense panel is planning to file another bail petition after Ragos finishes testimony. The next hearing is scheduled on November 25. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Johnson Manabat. Well, the filing of additional charges in the Percy Lapid murder case set for Monday. Mike Navalio now joins us with details. Mike, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. The Department of Justice is eyeing the filing of additional murder complaints against at least 10 personalities by Monday, according to Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla. Remulla earlier said they could file the additional raps by Saturday or Monday, but he explained earlier that the Philippine National Police and the National Bureau of Investigation are still discussing the cases, and they need to talk to 2 to 3 personalities who are, quote, very high in the chain in the Lapid case. Remulla declined to name any of the possible respondents, saying he'll leave it to the NBI and the PNP to disclose additional information. The new complaints will be different from the existing murder complaint that is being heard by the Department of Justice in connection with the Percy Lapid killing involving self-confessed gunman Joel Escorial and alleged middleman Christopher Bakoto. Escorial showed up at the preliminary investigation of the murder complaint this morning but did not submit additional statements. Bakoto was represented for the first time by his lawyer, Salvador Quimpo, who said he advised his client not to attend since they still need to check the complaint and affidavits of witnesses. But Quimpo said his client was surprised he was tagged in the Lapid killing, considering that he has been detained at a BJMP jail for the past 2 years, while on trial for drug possession and trafficking charges, as well as frustrated homicide and murder charges. He added his client also does not know Escorial and the other identified suspects. Brothers Israel and Edmond Dimakulangan are still at large, as well as certain Orly. Escorial identified the three as his companions when he shot radio commentator Percy Lapid in Espinas on October 3. The investigating prosecutors gave Bakoto and the other respondents until next Friday, November 11, to submit their counter affidavits. Attorney Danilo Pilahio, lawyer for the Mabasa family, says it's possible the new complaint in the Lapid case, which will be filed on Monday, may be consolidated with the existing murder complaint before the DOJ. A separate Villamor murder complaint could also be consolidated later on. Meanwhile, the 13 Bureau of Correction inmates who are now under NBI custody may stay at the NBI to address security concerns, according to DOJ spokesperson Mico Clavano. However, they could not qualify for the witness protection program because the law requires that state witnesses should not have been convicted of a crime involving moral turpitude for them to qualify. Clavano explained that since they were staying at a maximum security detention facility, they were most probably convicted of crimes involving moral turpitude and could not be state witnesses. But he assured them the DOJ will still look after their safety. He's not aware, though, if the inmates have applied for executive clemency. Inmates have previously expressed concerns for their safety after providing statements to the NBI.